all teachers, under whose guidance and support myself has achieved the highest percentage in the 10th class. Further, if I talk about myself and my family members, then my son has given me an opportunity to feel proud on his performance. One thing that I want to share at this moment, that my son was very much focused on his studies from 6th or 7th onwards. And he has made a goal from 6th, 7th onwards that he would like to become a researcher in future. So this was the key success for his achievement, that he has set a goal from the very beginning. So the concentration and setting goal was the main cause of his achievement. Thanks once again to ma'am, principal sir, and teachers, and wishing that the same support should be continued in class 11th and class 12th.
Shreshtha Lahiri from class 7th F. Ved Patel from class 7th B. Zainab Pathan from class 7th A. Kushagra Maheshwari from class 7th B. From class 8, Army Purge, class 8E. Muskan Mantija, class 8G. Shreya Khandelwal, class 8D. From class 9, Aryan Jihalia, class 9H.
Consistent efforts rather, and self-discipline, as well as the environment where they are nurtured. Definitely, I would like to thank the DPS, the management, the teachers for their constant efforts, and especially I would say Mohan sir and Amit sir for their extended help that always they gave whenever it was required. Beyond the curriculum, if you ask them anything, they are always available for all their help, and I think that only counts for which my child has scored this much percentage. And I've been here. So thank you, all of you. And I would say that all the best for the other students also to come in this, because I think my another child, Anshika, is also here. And I hope that I get another opportunity to be here.
Harshal Kumar Yadav, class 6B. Nana Uchal Kumar Dave, 6B. Nishit Barot, class 6B. Hriday Trivedi, class 6C. Chinmay Gaonkar, 6D. Arna Mitra, 6A. Vaishnavi Tripathi, 6A. Rishabh Ravi, 6A. Shridhar Dave, 6C. Shivam Kumar, 6D. Priyanshi Jain, 6F.
Tulsha, 8T. Srinivas Konala, 8T. Ari Ramesh Barbari, 8B. Anveshika Rath, 8A. Kumar Arjun Gupta, 8T. Vaidhavi Agarwal, 8A. Krish Shah, 8E. Rashmi Asim Shah, 8A. Kriya Bharat Kachwani, 8E. Pranoy Subir Ghosh, 8B.
Stop the position. Sahil Mangal, 10th D. Harshdayar, 10th E. Garbi Patel, 10th P. Shashank Sundar, 10th F. Vedehi Sharma, 10th G. Anand, 10th F. Lavanya Kumari Parmar, 10th G. Sakshi Chauhan, 10th C. And Bansari Patel from 10th A. Please give the applause to the class.
Which family they belong to, which country they belong to, which sex they belong to, which religion they belong to. For me, they all are children and they are our children. Dear friends, I don't know that how many of you understood the lyrics of that song. How many of you understood it? Thank you. That's a big message. That is the message. And it is beginning. Because everything what a person should have in life is beautifully displayed by the children. Your words, your deeds, your thoughts must be sweet. That is what the world is looking for. If I ask you, how many of you want to see your children happy in your life? Great. How many of you want to see your children successful in their life? Good, everyone. Now, what is happiness to you and what is success to you? That is important. Whether all the success people are happy or all happy people are successful people, we have to see that. One important message for the parents of this current generation. Whenever I think even servant is facing the same problem, they say that, sir, who has sutra me? You give up. But we cannot give up. And you won't feel that school and teachers are the last refuge, and you come back and pour all your tensions and all your worries to the principal or the teachers, and you feel that you'll leave. No, it's not that. Please try to understand that. Home is the first school and parents are the first teachers. Children learn a lot from the first school and from the first teachers. We have a lot of responsibilities in creating a good human being. You all should understand that. I think four words are very important for our life. Try to understand that. What is the difference between need and desire? Whenever a child makes a demand or asks for something, consider that whether it is a need or a desire. And decide that whether I should fulfill it right now or not. Dear parents, we all love our children. I am also a father of two children. It is our responsibility to fulfill all their needs, not the desires. When they grow up, let them fulfill their desires. Because this age has no limit. And at the same time, two more words, involvement and interference. Being a parent, don't interfere into their life, involve in them. Whether it is their personal growth, whether it is their character growth, whether it is character formation, be there. Your involvement is going to bring more fruits than involvement. The more you are going to involve, they are going to keep a gap with you. They will be going away from you. Because the current generation, they don't like interference. But they love involvement. They create a feeling that you are there. Create a feeling that yes, I am with you. But don't interfere in their freedom. Don't interfere with the learning and teaching learning process. Whatever the school, because every school will have their own policies, philosophies. Trust in the school, trust in the teachers. That is involvement. Come back if there is any suggestion. Talk to the concerned authorities. But interference is not good. It's not going to bring any fruit but involvement. So I wish all of you a happy parenting. Thanks a lot for inviting me. Thank you.